sure I got the mic on. Yeah. All right. So, all right. This is the last one I'm gonna do. I finally decided I'm just gonna go on and be cool, be nice. I'm not gonna use my, you know, Von Harris character. And we're gonna see what can happen. So now that this is what, April the 6th, every free agent that's been signed and, you know, so forth, players on teams, I already tell you right now, I just couldn't fit my boy Chris on the team. Just didn't have the room. Like, I mean, I could have fit him on the team, but he wouldn't have gotten playing time. So maybe next year, we'll see. We'll see what happens in free agency. But I did all trades. Got every team. Now I can, you know, controlling the team. Come ain't no small ball. Finna change all that up. Now finna have no small ball on the game. Putting players in their proper positions and so forth. But I did take Cleveland. Took about, you know, 30 minutes to go through and get the trades I could get. So I did all this before I took over all the teams, so I could adjust their rosters. And make it that they play all 13 players. Alright, so tripping. So we're gonna start from the back, work our way up to the front. No call ups, no send downs, nobody got waived, I didn't change the coaching, didn't hire anybody. Alright, the two players, the game automatically signed JJ Barea. It did that before I could even take control. So I did go sign Andre Robertson. Shooting guard, small forward. He got that defense. You know, I always want to build my teams around defense. So, did that. You can already see at the bottom of the screen some stuff that happened. All right, so you know I go trade crazy. First thing was, I'm like, if I'm going to do this, I'm going to play point, and I got to control, you know, somebody that I really want to play with. So, I went and got Dejounte Murray. I went looking for him. They were going to throw in Pirtle. I was like, I could use the center, and you know, Pirtle, my boy. So definitely got rid of Sexton and got rid of Barea. Then I went looking for Mitchell, got Mitch. They were willing to give him for just the second round pick. But I was like, we got to get rid of those, like, some of these contracts, man. So we let, you know, I threw Seti in there for him. Had to let Seti go. You're like 73 overall, you're making, you know, like 8-9 million. Like, nah, I gotta let you go, baby. You know, I had to go get my boy Chris Dunn for backup. The Bucks were willing to just give us the second round pick. But, the Hawks were willing just to give a second round pick. So I'm like, nah, we have no use for Dylan Windler. He has no defensive awareness. So let's throw him in there, get him up off the team. Yeah, I know. I love Larry. But, you know, I saw that they was willing to give up Tyrese Halliburton. So I'm like, yo, I can have a, you know, young guy. 80 overall. I need somebody to fill up the two position. And he's got defensive, you know, skills and awareness. So Wayne got the young guy, gave up Larry. All right. So then it was like, okay, really got to get these contracts off of here. So I really kept trying to find somewhere nice for Kevin to go. But, like, yo. You know, we just, like, I was trying to send him somewhere decent. You know, they was trying to give Halliburton for Kevin Love, but, like, he don't even fit in. They got enough power forwards, man. So, they don't, you know, I didn't want to do that. I don't want to overload a team. You know, even if the computer will let you do it, it's like, I don't want to do that. So, unfortunately, had to send him to Oklahoma City. It's business, baby. Ain't nothing personal. You know. We just took Justin Robinson. I don't even know who that guy is, but, you know, hey, he's like 67 overall. He ain't making no money. So, you know, it was really just to get that money off the books. I probably should have asked for, like, more for the trade, but I was just like, man, I don't care. We just getting the money off the books, man. All right. So then it was Darius Garland. I had no reason to have him at point now that I got done, and I got my and Dejounte Murray. And I wanted to get rid of Dean Wade. He can't even rebound. So the only thing I saw was the Clippers. Clippers, you know, they were willing to take them. So I'm like, you know, hey, send them out there to the Clippers, you know. And then I didn't want Patrick Beverley in that contract. So I'm like, hell, Oklahoma City got money to spend, and they could, you know, take another point guard on. So send him to the Clippers. We get Tony Bradley. Now we got a backup power forward. All right. So then it was Taurean Prince's contract. Damian Dotson, he was now, like, you know, deep on the depth chart. He's getting $2 million. So I'm like, you know, let's get him on out of here. Send him to the West. We ain't got to face him but twice a year. We pick up Nwamba. You know, he played for the Cavaliers a couple years ago. Defense. That's what it was about. It's about having that defense. So got Nwamba there. You know, he's got like B-plus defense and so forth. 6'5", 219, nice size, whatever. He can play the two and the three. Kelly Olynyk. That contract, I didn't want that contract. So I was like, hey, since the Kings, you know, is willing to take on money, you know, we just went and got Harkless. Harkless can play defense, and he can be a swing man, small forward, shooting guard. So, you know, we did that. I know I was like, hey, you know, they got enough power forwards, but I'm like, forget it at this point, man. Like he got, you know, he's only like a 74, 75 overall. So I'm like, you know, he's not going to take playing time from anybody. All right. So then we just had to get rid of guy Justin Robinson. He was no reason for him to even be on the team. I get two downs about the Warriors. I'm like, look, we just got to get rid of him. I wasn't going to try to cut him and still be stuck with that little million-dollar contract. I'm just cheap like that. So, you know, it was only two teams that really was offering draft picks. So we just took the one with the Warriors because they could use another point. And then that's why we went and signed Andre after that. All right, so that's it. That's the roster. The first game is Portland. So we got to go down here. I went the wrong way. I should have went the other way. I'm tripping. We're going to get this one game in real quick, and then I got to get some sleep. Back to work tomorrow. All right. So, Kanter can stay there. Yurik is staying. I decided I'm going to, like, let it go down to 245. So, you can be 245 and still play center. You ain't gotta be 250. Cause just ain't that many big guys no more. So, I don't know, man. Power forward center, like, that's crazy. You gotta be able to shoot if I'm gonna let you play shooting guard. And then some guys, they just only going to be small forwards. Alright, so we got Powell. Look at this. Like, why do they have Powell at the three, man? And you know if I move him to the two, he's going to drop down in rating. But man, I hate that about this game. I feel like so many people got gray beards. I'm going to fix this real quick. I could have did this off camera. Off stream. He doesn't even have any playmaking skills. Why? Whatever. Like, whatever, man. Everybody gotta go 13 deep. I'm already locked on to Deontay, so. Same thing, we're gonna wear this ugly uniform now and get it out the way. We're not playing at home. Let's get this out the way now. I think we went with the wine for everything. Yeah, because it's like, that's definitely black. Interesting matchup here. Interesting matchup. So they still put Melo at the four. Yeah, I got to take on Dame. Man, I hope I don't mess up Deontay Murray. All right. is he not rolling to the basket? He let me catch up. Captain Well, nah, Kendall's more of an offensive player. It's a finger on it, but just can't quite come up with the steal. Appreciate the effort, though, making his presence felt to this. I'm glad we got to see the Mobile One block once more. What a play. Man, he's all over that shot, has it ran the whole way against the position he needs to make a play. Tries to free up the inbound. Here's Allen. Well, you better put that back up. Yes, Jared. Thank you. I thought he was going to get a nice little basket. He got blocked. That's a more of an offensive player.
Of how you carry yourself out on the floor when you deal with adversity.
was up by 12. All right, dude.
Carmelo, first half in the books. What do you need to focus on in the second half to get this win?
All right, David, thank you. We'll be back just after halftime to get the third quarter started. The 2K Sports Halftime Show. Ernie Johnson here with Shaq and Penny, and a favorite time of the year as we're halfway through one of the first games of this fresh NBA season. It's Cleveland out on top at halftime. They have the six-point lead. Penny, what's yours? The rebounding margin says a lot about this game. They've been the better team in that department so far, no doubt. Now, I love the aggressive attitude that they came out with tonight, buddy. And that's the difference. And they're not going to get out. Looking at Portland, Shaq, your thoughts.
When you think about giving up three or four extra turnovers, that can mean 8 or 9 points at the end of the game. That's why every coach preaches it. The basketball. The bottom line, they need to protect the ball and play under control.
He ain't got 18 on me.
That about wraps it up. Time now.
Got maybe 10 on me.
The game. We go to Kevin Harlan for the call.
So they were trying to set that screen at the top. That was a stupid animation. Yeah, good job. Alex Burke passing, yo.
Phenomenal alley-oop slam there. They are taking advantage of a team that looks lost out there. Trailblazers trail by 10. And with Melo not having to bear so much of the score.
Oh, they wouldn't even let me get out there.
Yeah, especially since...
That's so whack, man. They wouldn't even... I'm holding down the turbo, but they wouldn't even let me run out there. Keep forgetting that he's not the center.
Thank you.
season for him last year. Averaged about 22 points per, 4 assists, 4 rebounds. But to have a scorer like him consistently deliver you points makes such a big difference for a team.
Take him to the basket. Oh, my God, man. You could have took him to the basket. Damn, man. What? is he shooting a jumper? Watch, he gonna mess it up while the rotation where I'm not gonna be able to come in at the end of the game.
just had to put your hands up, man. I ain't mad at the intensity. You just got to put your hands up, though. Play Melo at the four. Shooting guard. Call a timeout now, you stupid fucking idiot.
Thank you.
You calling the time? This game's stupid as fuck, bro. I'm already ready done with this shit. Putting fucking Tony Bradley at shooting guard. What is it doing my character? What is it doing? Potential fouls, man. Stupid as fuck. Gotta fire this damn coach. This is fucking pointless. Why are we putting him on the free throw line? Just trap his ass. They got him celebrating for. I didn't fucking do that. All I went for the regular steal. They did that shit out on their own. Bradley is shooting guards. What kind of stupid ass chicken? Dumb as fuck ass game, man. Get one highlight. The game we only lost by five. We didn't get one highlight. Why didn't they have to play their whole team, man? Oh, see, man, this is the bullshit, bro.